Hey, I'm standing here on a platform, as you can see, in what is known as Fort Welch. Fort Welch is part of the Union lines here at Petersburg. We're on the western front of Petersburg. And if I turn this way, you can see all the infantry lines and forts and things that are all up through here, artillery emplacements. But a lot happens here. And from this vantage point, we can see an entire field behind us. There's a Civil War trail sign here. It's got great description of what happens. But I'm going to tell you a little bit about what happens. On the right-hand side, well, the right, Confederate right, Union left. Since we're on the Union side, we'll say the left. But behind me is the Battle of People's Farm. That's fought October 2nd, 1864. That battle is unsuccessful for the Union as far as what they're trying to do. What they're trying to do at the Battle of People's Farm is capture the Boyden Plank Road, which is an intermediate supply line for the South. They're unable to do that. They can't capture the road. However, they are able to capture a foothold in this area. And they're going to build upon that. As you can see, they end up building forts and artillery emplacements and things like that. The next thing that's going to happen is going to happen on the Union right, the Confederate left. And that's on March 25th, 1865. That is the Battle of Jones Farm. And what's going to happen, there's a Confederate picket line that's going to be out here. And the Union troops are going to capture that picket line. Now, that picket line being captured is a prelude to what happens April 2nd, 1865. From this point, directly behind me, this entire field that's right here, goes all the way over to the cornfield. On April 2nd, 1865, there's a massive, massive Union assault. The entire line moves. As it moves, it goes across about a mile of field, and it attacks the Confederate line, which is now at what is known as the Pamplin Civil War Park. A mile from this very area. As the Union Army attacks, they are able to break through. Why are they able to break through? Because Grant, the entire time, as we discussed at the Weldon Railroad, has been stretching and stretching his army out, which has caused Robert E. Lee to stretch his army. Stretching his army so far to what is known as the breaking point. The breakthrough at the Petersburg lines will occur a mile from where we are standing, and that will begin the end of the Civil War. As Grant's army breaks through, Lee is forced to surrender Petersburg and Richmond and retreat. He will retreat all the way to Appomattox Courthouse, where he will ultimately surrender his army to Grant there on April 9th. So a mere 7 days from April 2nd when this breakthrough occurs. This is just awesome looking. This is one spot I've never been to where, you know, you could see the field. This is where the Union troops marched directly across this field and ended the Siege of Petersburg right here. Also, up here at the breakthrough point, General A.P. Hill, commander of the 3rd Corps of the Army of Northern Virginia, is going to be shot and killed, right up here, 7 days short of the end of the Civil War. The Army of Northern Virginia lost a lot of commanders in this war, a lot of very good generals, A.P. Hill being one of them. So, it's really cool to be here. Again, this is Fort Welch, and this is the Union lines. There's the signs for the People's Farm is actually back a little ways, but you got a little over a mile worth of trail here to be able to walk. It's part National Park Service, Civil War Trust, and Pamplin Civil War Park. You do have to pay to get into the Pamplin Civil War Park, just so you know, but if you've never been there, that is a really cool place to go. They have the Museum of the Civil War Soldier there. And they have a farm there. They have, you know, the trenches and the breakthrough points. It is just amazing to be able to go there and see what they have. So if you haven't been there, I encourage you to go to that. Again, you know, coming to places like this, a beautiful day. So I'm enjoying myself, getting a little battlefield therapy in. I hope you're enjoying yourself watching these videos. And I hope you get out and enjoy a little bit of history. Thank you for watching. And keep chasing history. Thank you.